What appears to have happened is the patients got injected into the area around their spine. These are patients that had severe back pain and were receiving steroid injections for their back pain. Now, unfortunately, the steroid injections that they got were obtained from a compounding center, and these injections were contaminated with a rare fungus. So in essence, they got the fungus injected right into their spinal canal. I've seen cases of fungal meningitis before, but this particular fungus that's causing the meningitis is extremely rare. To my knowledge, it's never caused meningitis before. Most of the patients present with symptoms of meningitis, and those types of symptoms can be fever, headache, and stiff neck. Some patients also have stroke-like symptoms. Patients can also present with an infection at the site of the steroid injection. Exorohilum is the name of the fungus that's been identified in most of the cases. The fungus is very difficult to treat, and it's difficult to treat for several reasons. Fungi in general are more difficult to treat than bacteria. The drugs that we have don't work as well, and also there are limited options in terms of antifungal drugs. What the Centers of Disease Control is recommending is a drug called voriconazole given at high doses. Now, the high doses are necessary because one needs the drug to penetrate into the cerebral spinal fluid and into the central nervous system. I think one always needs to be careful in terms of what gets administered to patients, and one must be careful in terms of the source of the drug. I think there's been a lot in the press, rightfully so, about the New England Compounding Center that made these pharmaceuticals or compounded these pharmaceuticals. The type of quality control at this compounding center was not nearly the type of quality control that one would see at a Food and Drug Administration approved facility. Fortunately, at UMass Memorial Hospital, we didn't use that drug, so our patients are not at risk.